Hey everybody, I'm Matthew Morris. Today is Thursday, December 31st, which means it's time for the last weekly shop update of the year. So what's been going on in the shop this week and in the rest of 2015? Well, this week, the first thing I want to talk about is the two people who are going to get the router planes from me. One being the Stanley 71 here, and the other being the Sargent 61 here as well. First off, I want to thank everybody who sent an email with photos or links or text, you know, your description. I was really great of all of you. I really appreciate it. And for each and every single one of you who sent something in, I have something for you, as well as the two people who are going to get these. So for everybody who sent something in, I will be emailing you a coupon code, which will get you access to the Scotch Cabinet class on the MM Wood Studio Online Woodworking School. There are a couple of you who already have classes in the school as well that you own, and for those people, I will be working with you to get you another class that you don't own of equal value to the Scotch Cabinet class. So that's my gift in the Christmas spirit to everybody who sent me an email. Thank you so much. I didn't want any of you not to get something. So the two lucky winners are now, the funny thing is, for one of you, it worked out really well. One requested a particular plane, the other said that he was just looking for one of them in general. So it really worked out really well. I didn't have two people trying to get the same router plane. So first off, Jim, thank you so much for sending me the link to your video on YouTube. I'll have a link to Jim's channel and the video he sent me about why he wants the Stanley 71. So Jim, the Stanley 71, she's all yours. Now I do need a address to send it to you. That'd be really appreciated. I will email you, or you can email me. The second winner is Kirk. Kirk, thank you so much for your email, for watching the Matt and Matthew show, myself, and your great email. So tell your wife that you will be getting the Sargent 61. But again, Kirk, I do need an address from you so I can ship this guy off to you. And once you do a little bit of honing on this guy for the blade, hopefully it'll serve you very well. So thank you again to everybody who wrote in. Give me a day or two and I will be sending you guys coupon codes to get the classes on the school, plus Kirk and Jim, you guys as well. Thank you so much. So let's get into what happened in the shop with the coffee table, and then we'll talk about 2015. So as you can see, the coffee tables got drawer handles on it. So I actually finished the handles. This was a lot of fun. Last week when I did the update, the week before, when I was actually healthy enough to be in the shop working, I had just started shaping the rest of the handles. So right here, you can kind of see the curvature on the handle right here. And this is really nice. It worked out really well. This was from using the backside of the bit to relieve this material using a curved fence. And after I got all of this wasted away, and I did that very slowly, just moved the fence just a little bit every time, and with also moved my feather board, the whole thing slowly to creep up onto that fit. Now the fit wasn't perfect on both sides. What I mean by that is the first curve that I made right here did not necessarily match this curve right over here. So in order to make those two guys match, I took a half inch dowel with some 80 grit paper on it, and I sanded until everything was nicely feathered into each other and all of the curves met. And then rounding over all the edges on the forward part and some sanding there, and then some hand sanding on the back part to make it nice and soft as you grasp the pole. So that worked out really well. And with these guys done and attached, well, I had to attach them. So to attach them, I found out what the center distance was, or the center would be for the drawer fronts. And then I created a MDF jig, or just a piece of MDF basically, be attached to the bottom of the drawer, and then that would push the handle up so it was centered. And then every time I attached the handle, I just made sure it was nice and centered, and I could reference these 5/16 of an inch plugs that I put into the drawer fronts. At the drill press, I drilled some pilot holes, and then I used some clamps to hold the handles down once I centered them, and with some number 6 screws, I was able to attach the handles. And I think everything turned out really great. The drawers themselves slide very nicely, some great action back and forth on both of them. So I'm really happy with these. I think they look great. And the next step after that was to start working on all of the ebony plugs in, well, for the base. So I started putting my 1/4 inch plugs in, and then I moved on to the 5/16 of an inch plugs on the drawers. Now, as you'll see, there's two flush plugs here on the sides, and these just got cut, hammered in, just proud of the surface, and then with a block plane and some water to soften up the grain, I brought these down to their final thickness, and with a little bit of sanding, everything was ready to go, and a little bit of buffing on the ebony too, and they really shine nicely. And then I started on the 5/16 of an inch plugs for the drawer fronts. Now, next week what I need to work on is the 5/16 of an inch bars that are gonna go inside of the handles. And of course, the rest of these plugs all over. So the handles here will get bars that are 5/16 of an inch that are rounded over, and the handles as well. And then of course, the rest of these flush plugs on the sides. So that was a really good week here. This project is progressing very well. Unfortunately, I was sick for, I think, a combination of a total of a month. Otherwise, this project, I have no doubt, would be done this year. So that gets me into everything for 2015. I have a little list here. So let's start on that. So February of this year, I made a commitment to do a weekly shop update. So I haven't been doing these for an entire year yet, but this February I did. So, and that's been just a lot of fun. I haven't missed a week, and it's just a great experience to share what's going on in the shop with you guys, hear your feedback, comments, questions, etc. So thank you for everybody who watches the weekly shop update. Matt Cremona and myself started the Matt and Matthew Show, and that's been a lot of fun, meeting some really great people because of the show. And I made a commitment to doing at least 3 projects a year, and thus starting the yearly membership for the school. So with that in mind, I have completed 3 projects just this year alone. The Scotch cabinet, which I actually built 3 of those in total, the dedicated sharpening station, and the Gamble House rocking chair. Now, the Gamble House rocking chair was an enormous commitment in time, materials, and energy. That was a 4 or 5 month build in total, easily 300 hours, and before that, 9 months of research. So that was just a chair I've been actually waiting to build for years, and I was so happy that I get to sit in it. And I can't wait to see you guys building that rocking chair as well. Now, I would have finished, as I said, the 4th project in 1 year, which would have been this guy. So that's okay, no big deal. It'll get done in the first part of next year, and then next will be the Nakashima-inspired dining table, the planes, the set of bench planes, some other tools, and a brand new tool cabinet. So those are some great projects to look forward to in 2016 for me, hopefully for you guys to watch, and maybe to build as well. So I also launched Quick Tips. I did 13 Quick Tips this year, and these are probably my best watched videos as a group. Lots of quick views on these videos. I think you guys are liking them because of that, which I really appreciate. And they're very short, a quick tip, usually about 2 minutes, and they get you a really nice piece of information really fast. I went to Woodworking in America in September. That was a ton of fun. Met a lot of great people, fellow YouTubers, woodworkers alike. Everybody there was really great. Had a booth for the school to show people the classes, and people signed up, which I really felt great about. And I vlogged every single day of the show. That was a lot of fun. A lot of great nights, 4 in the morning, putting videos up, and then people like Braxton, who has a channel as well, which I'll link up to down below. About 5 minutes after I posted the video, checking them out from the hotel lobby before he went to bed that night. So that was a ton of fun. And then to top it all off, I signed the contract, as you guys know, with Popular Woodworking to have my first class with them, which is the Gamble House side table on their Popular Woodworking University. And that's really cool. I know that they hopefully want some more. They've talked about it, and I'm looking forward to doing some more collaborations with them. So I think overall it was a really great 2015. I couldn't ask for anything more, and I'm really looking forward to a great 2016 for myself and hopefully everybody else who watches this channel as well. So as always, please subscribe to the channel, share it with your friends, and hit that thumbs up button if you like this video. If you're watching this on Facebook, hit that like button, share it on your timeline, and go over to the MM Wood Studio page and like that page on Facebook as well. And head over to mmwoodstudio.com, check out all the great classes that are up there for you to take individually or as a yearly subscription. And have a great, happy New Year's, and I'll see you guys in the next year, 2016. It's gonna be an amazing one. Have a great week in the shop, guys.